What is quasi-experimental research design? Quasi-experimental research design is a type of research methodology that shares similarities with experimental designs but lacks complete randomization of participants into groups. In quasi-experiments, researchers do not have full control over assigning participants to experimental and control groups due to practical or ethical constraints. The term quasi reflects the partial or somewhat compromised experimental nature of this research approach. Imagine you want to test if studying with music helps students remember better. In a true experiment, you'd randomly assign some students to study with music and some without. But in real life, you might not be able to control everything, like students' preferences. That's where quasi-experimental design comes in. You still have a control group and an experimental group, but you don't randomly assign subjects. There are five types of quasi-experimental research designs. Let us understand each of this in detail. 1. Non-equivalent group research design. A non-equivalent groups research design is a type of quasi-experimental designs which involves studying two or more groups that are not equivalent at the outset of the study. This means that the groups being compared are not randomly assigned and there may be inherent differences between them. In a study evaluating the impact of a workplace training program, researchers may compare the performance of employees who voluntarily choose to participate in the program with those who do not. The groups are non-equivalent at the start because individuals self-select into the training, potentially introducing differences in motivation, skills, or attitudes. 2. Time series research design. Time series research design is a type of quasi-experimental designs which involve studying the changes in a variable or a set of variables over time. It helps researchers analyze trends, patterns, and relationships that may exist within a specific time frame. Imagine you want to understand the trends in stock prices for a particular company over the past year. By collecting daily or weekly stock prices, you can create a time series data set. This design allows you to identify patterns such as whether the stock consistently rises or falls during certain months, helping investors make informed decisions. 3. Interrupted time series research design. Interrupted time series, ITS, is a type of quasi-experimental research designs used in scientific studies to assess the impact of an intervention or event on a particular variable over time. In simple terms, researchers collect data at multiple time points and then something interrupts the usual pattern, allowing them to analyze how the intervention or event influences the observed outcome. Suppose a community launches an anti-smoking campaign to reduce smoking rates. Researchers track the monthly cigarette sales before and after the campaign. The interruption is the initiation of the anti-smoking campaign and the study assesses whether there's a noticeable decline in cigarette sales following the intervention. 4. Regression discontinuity research design. Regression discontinuity design, RDD, is a type of quasi-experimental research designs used to evaluate the causal impact of an intervention or treatment by exploiting a natural or imposed threshold. The basic idea is that individuals just above or below a cutoff point are similar in all aspects except for their exposure to the treatment. This design helps researchers isolate the treatment effect and draw more credible causal inferences. Consider a situation where a new policy mandates reduced sentences for individuals with criminal offenses just below a specific severity level. RDD can be applied by comparing the outcomes of individuals on either side of this threshold. This helps researchers evaluate the effectiveness of the policy in reducing recidivism or promoting rehabilitation. 5. Counterbalance research design. A counterbalance research design is a method used in scientific studies to eliminate or control the potential effects of order or sequence in presenting stimuli or conditions. It ensures that all possible orders or sequences of the experimental conditions are tested, allowing researchers to account for any order effects that may influence the results. In a clinical trial testing, the effectiveness of a new medication compared to a placebo, a counterbalance design would involve randomly assigning participants to either start with the medication or the placebo. This ensures that any observed effects are not solely due to the order in which participants receive the treatments. In conclusion, quasi-experimental designs offer practical solutions when a full experimental approach is challenging.